rising, as I said, into the mid-70s. Plenty of sunshine, and tomorrow we'll be flirting with 80 degrees before it's all done. So, a great day today. More temperatures will rise for tomorrow. Amy, it looks like, boy, 80 degrees by Monday.
Fantastic. Thank you, Clay. You can get the latest news and weather in the NBC Washington app. For now, back to the Today Show.
That is Ryan Gosling singing alongside his Fall Guy co-star Emily Blunt as they reminisce about the Barbenheimer craze on last night's new episode of Saturday Night Live. Gosling hosted the show with musical guest Chris Stapleton. The virtuoso we all know as Alicia Keys started out as another little girl whose mom made her take piano lessons. Alicia took to them better than most. She had her first record deal at 16, a number one song and album at 20, and has 16 Grammys to her name so far. Alicia's mother was an actress who worked several jobs while living with her daughter in a New York building full of artists. Now, Keys, who shares two sons with her husband, the producer Swizz Beatz, is set to open a Broadway show where she has had a hand in everything from the music to the casting, right down to the font on the marquee. Alicia and I got together in New York this week at the Schubert Theater, where Hell's Kitchen will debut on Saturday night.
Decade in the making. After a sold-out run off-Broadway, Hell's Kitchen, a musical inspired by the early life of Alicia Keys, has moved uptown.
What does it feel like to be sitting here now, just a few days from opening night of your Broadway show, Hell's Kitchen?
I feel shitty because I know the time that we've taken to build this. It's about a rush job. It's been years and years of development, and I feel proud of that. And I feel like you can't rush greatness.
At the center of the story is Allie, a young woman growing up in the Hell's Kitchen neighborhood of Manhattan, while discovering music, navigating a first love, and pushing teenage boundaries with her mother.
So, to be clear, this is not autobiographical. People might come in and say, oh, I'm watching the story of Alicia Keys' life. It's not.
Right.
Where are the differences as you see them?
Allie is kind of a little bit more gullible, a little bit more naive even. A 17-year-old girl is trying to find her way, feeling quite rebellious, looking for her muse, her passion, being raised by a single mother who's quite overprotective in New York City, which you can understand why. She's really been quite protected, and so she's just starting to find her wings and her space. It's intentionally not autobiographical, and I think ultimately what it really is, and this I can relate to very much, is a love story between a mother and a daughter.
How important was that relationship to the story?
Telling a mother-daughter story is really, really important. There are many father-son stories, there are not many mother-daughter stories. And if you think about it, it's such a special relationship, such a unique relationship, and so telling that story is really dynamic.
Keys wrote new music for the show, but rest assured, the hits find their way in.
I love the way you rearranged the songs that we all know and love. So how did you think about incorporating that in the story and in the dialogue?
I love that you said that because it's very intentional and everyone had their eyes on the music. Of course, putting it together, I intentionally wanted to deconstruct the expectation of what you might get from the song. I didn't want you to come in here and just kind of think you were going to get what you thought you were going to get. You're not, musically, actually. And so there's so many ways that the songs are arranged and composed that tell the story of what you're experiencing. And even I'm like, why did I think to do that song in the back? I've performed it like hundreds of times, but I never thought to, for, it never meant that position thrilling as the songwriter.
And how far is the building you grew up in from here?
A couple hours over, a couple hours down.
But a universe away.
A whole universe away.
The 43-year-old Keys was born Alicia Cook and raised by her single mother in Hell's Kitchen, a then green New York neighborhood just steps from the glittering lights of Broadway.
Growing up in New York City, I walked all of these streets, all of these blocks. They were unattainable to me. How could I ever imagine, as a 7-year-old or a 9-year-old or a 10-year-old, that this could be possible? I couldn't, you know? They would stand on the TKTS line and get the inexpensive ticket so we could go to see different shows. And I remember seeing shows that really open me up to so much of what Broadway is.
Did your dream begin when you first sat in front of the piano at 7 years old?
Yeah, because I was able to unlock a world that I had no idea what it was going to be able to, what doors it would be able to take me through. And I mean, that's the reason why I chose Keys for my last name, because I played the keys and the piano keys, but because they opened doors.
Keys graduated from her performing arts high school at 16 as class valedictorian and began to pursue a career in music.
No one knew what to do with me. They didn't know how to. They were like, what is this? How do we break this? How do we get this on the radio? What do we do? So it was a journey of divine timing and people who cared to make it all come together. But you never know how it's going to happen.
In 2001, the world fell for Alicia Keys. Her debut album, Songs in A Minor, went to number one and earned her 5 Grammy Awards. Combining classically trained piano talent with the R&B influences on which she grew up, Keys has become one of the best-selling artists in the history of music, with anthems about her hometown. Yeah.
Documentary, you may have saved it.
See you tomorrow.
We love you. We'll see you here on the Family Feud.
Show until next time. This is Peter Tomorrow on behalf of the Bukkake Rug saying thanks for pressing your luck. Bye bye.
So anyway, we have just 10 seconds to say goodbye. We'll see you tomorrow. So long.
Bye bye. Yeah.
We got 5 seconds.
Oh no, we have 3, 2, 1.
Bye. Bye.